I want to ask the Sultan of Sokoto and all those idiots he's been cavorting with, telling us that our education is fueled by illiteracy and ignorance. Are you a learned man? I'm asking the Sultan of Sokoto. As idiotic as you are you a learned man? You're dressing like an Arab. Are you an Arab man? Are you Arab? I'm asking you. You are from a tribe of pastorals. You move cattle. You don't know what having a shelter is all about because you are nomadic. So when people in the south are clamoring for shelter, you will not understand it. You are Fulani. You are a nomad. You are a gentleman. You know nothing about settling down anywhere. That is number one. Number two, you claim that what we are doing is fueled by misinformation. Are you telling me that the Nieti Allah killing people and driving us away or intending to drive us away from our land, that we don't know what we are doing? We are doing it wrongly. So, Fashiranti's daughter, Yoruba leader that you killed, you, Sultan of Sokoto, because all of you are part and parcel of this wave of terrorism in the zoo. Are you saying that we should not be conscious of that? Are you saying that when you come, bring your terrorists from across the Sahel to come into our land to occupy it? Possibly. That we should keep quiet, is that what you're saying? So by keeping quiet, we are not informed. When we speak against all these things, we are ill-informed. That is how stupid and backwards you Janjaweed people are. Religion is a thing of choice. You can't force anybody to accept. That is why even the Western world abandoned the debate over religion. Because religion makes men mad. Allow people to worship whatever they want to worship. It is their business. You cannot convince them. As where I come from is called Onye Nigeria. You and your God. How your God talks to you in spirit is how you're going to behave. Nobody is entitled to encroach into that very space. If it was the original brand of Islam that you're bringing, maybe perhaps I'm even beginning to listen to you. But you are a Wahhabi. You are a Janjaweed. You believe in spreading your religion through conquest and war and want to bring it into my land. Your forebears tried that about 300 years ago and they failed at the plains of Benin. And you have failed and you will continue to fail. And for daring to achieve it, people struggle for survival. For you to attribute our agitation and self-determination to illiteracy and misinformation goes to show that you are the one who is an illiterate and you are the one who is misinformed. I'm talking about the stupid, idiotic Sultan of Sokoto. The smelly rat that can't even wash two times in a day. Not even two times in a day. All he does is to perfume himself morning and night. You people think you can bring your armies into our land to take over our land from us? Is that what you think? You can run to Yoruba all you like. It's the Yorubas that have time to listen to your garbage and to your nonsense. It's the Yoruba that can listen to such rubbish. And for the likes of Punch newspaper that carried this very news, I feel sorry for some of you. Some Yoruba media, they think they're very smart. I'm telling you, they think they are somehow very smart. We will keep doing this and then Tinubu will get into power and we'll begin to enjoy how mistaken all of you are. Because you are going to be consumed. They said more needs to be done. This is what, according to the stupid conference they had in Lagos, more needs to be done in teaching younger Nigerians about the nation's history. What is the nation's history? What history is that? Is Nigeria a nation? Do you even, you claim we are suffering from illiteracy and misinformation. You as a Sultan don't even know the meaning or definition of the word nation. You have no idea what a nation is all about. And I will educate you. Because you're a Janjaweed, you're not learning. Some of you illiterate traditional rulers, you think that somehow you are smart. You can outsmart everybody else. But you cannot. Because you people are the ones who are illiterate. All of you are illiterate in the zoo. Everybody, once you rise up and you say you're a Nigerian, I know that some of you is the exact reason why white people treat us with contempt and disdain every blessing. And I don't blame them. You know me, I don't believe in racism. A white man can be as racist as he likes towards us. I don't give a damn. Because we brought it upon ourselves. Our stupidity. Students, I'm telling you the truth. When you have idiots like the Sultan of Sokoto prancing all over the place, the idiot doesn't work. Not one single day does he go to, he does nothing. As a Sultan, he cannot stop even the terrorism and insurgency ravaging the north. But he's coming to the south to come and preach to you idiots in Lagos, and you're listening to that fool. You're listening to him. That idiot, ask yourself, what has this fool done for us? Do we have electricity in the zoo? Even the employment that those that went before tried to establish, these idiots now in power, they ruined everything. No refinery is working, which means that no graduate of petroleum engineering will ever find a job in Nigeria as long as you allow these fools to continue to deceive you about your stupid one Nigeria. We are illiterates, and they are the ones who are learned. Learned. It's only in all this nonsense, what an elderly man saw sitting down. What have you done? If you collection of idiotic elders have done anything, at least by now, there will be electricity, there will be no insurgency, there will be no terrorism. Fulani will not be running all over the place, people will be to savagely kill and slaughter. You people are failures. All of you are failures, claiming your elders, elder statesman, elder this. You are all failures. You claim we are suffering from illiteracy and misinformation. You, as a Sultan, don't even know the meaning or definition of the word nation. You have no idea what a nation is all about. And I will educate you. Because you're a Janjaweed, you're not learning. Some of you illiterate traditional rulers, you think that somehow you are smart. You can outsmart everybody else. But you cannot. Because you people are the ones who are illiterate. All of you are illiterate in the zoo. Everybody, once you rise up and you say you're a Nigerian, I know that some of you is the exact reason why white people treat us with contempt and disdain every place. And I don't blame them. You know me, I don't believe in racism. A white man can be as racist as he likes towards us. I don't give a damn, because we brought it upon ourselves. Our stupidity. Students, I'm telling you the truth. When you have idiots like the Sultan of Sokoto prancing all over the place, the idiot doesn't work. Not one single day does he go to, he does nothing. As a Sultan, he cannot stop even the terrorism and insurgency ravaging the north. But he's coming to the south to come and preach to you idiots in Lagos, and you're listening to that fool. You're listening to him. That idiot, ask yourself, what has this fool done for us? Do we have electricity in the zoo? Even the employment that those that went before tried to establish, these idiots now in power, they ruined everything. No refinery is working. Which means that no graduate of petroleum engineering will ever find a job in Nigeria as long as you allow these fools to continue to deceive you about your stupid one Nigeria. I am older than the Sultan of Sokoto. He's a little boy. It's because of that stupid shit he ties on his head. You think he's old. He's a little boy. That idiot is a little boy. Fulani will see madness they have never seen before. Fulani, by the time we are done in this very battle, I'm telling you the truth, the Hausa peasants will rise against you. You'll be returned to the Kutajalon from whence you came. It is the Yoruba that is indulging you. Yoruba people are the ones indulging Fulani. Yoruba is the ones indulging you people. Without Yoruba, you cannot have the mouth to talk rubbish all the time. Down to my foot. You're a little boy with a chip on your head. You claim you're an elder. What stupid elder are you, I'm asking you? Are you a scholar of Islam? All of you idiots in the north, what do you know about Islam, I ask you? What do you know? Do you know it was Islam that brought algebra into mathematics? Do you know it was Islam that gave us even ice cream that you're licking today? Do you know that ice cream came from the Arabs? Are you aware of that? You know nothing, you idiots claiming you are scholars. You know nothing about Islam. Do you know about the medical advances that Islam brought to mankind? Do you know that Islam and the old Sultanate, are you aware that they funded education? Are you aware that those people were at the cutting edge of science? I'm talking about Islam, yes, cutting edge of science. For those of you, you same Sultan, you idiot, we are the one supporting Boko Haram, saying no to Western education. That going to school is not very good. I'm asking you, do you know that the mathematics you write today, algebra, do you know that algebra is an invention of Islamic education. You know, you don't even know all these things because you're foolish. You need to remove that bandage, that bedsheet you got on your head, so that oxygen and fresh air can get your brain. You people are sick. And to all those people in Yoruba land, you keep allowing all this nonsense all the time. The Sultan is a young boy. He's eating all of you. And you're falling for it, idiots everywhere. No wonder a white man can kneel on your neck in America and kill you. No wonder they can come to Africa and bring virus to experiment on us. We are useless, beyond useless. I'm telling you. Black people are useless. Useless. Listening to fools like that. And your life is a misery. Somebody is telling you are a graduate in a country where there is no concerted effort to create employment for people. And you telling me that you believe in such a country? Is that what you're telling me? These are the same people that closed down four refineries. Four. Each refinery could have employed nothing less than 10,000 people. Somebody should go and tell the Sultan of Sokoto and his side chick, Tinubu. All this nonsense you fools are doing was in the past, when there was no means of communication. When you controlled NTA, controlled everybody, as you're still controlling the likes of Punch newspaper today. Yoruba journalism is a disease. Yoruba journalism is a curse. It is a disease. They have no business being in journalism. Journalism is not meant for cowards. You must rise up to radical. Look at Dele Giwa. He wrote the truth and he spoke the truth. Dele Giwa, after him, all this nonsense you have, they are no longer journalists. Anywhere brown envelope goes, they pursue it. These idiots should stop talking rubbish. They're talking about security challenges. There is nothing called insecurity in Nigeria. It is a case of bad government. Why do I say that? Because let us start from the known to the unknown. Rather than even expanding the industrial base of Nigeria, they embarked upon shutting everything down. They kept devaluing the currency that now, from 86 kobo to $1, listen, from 86 kobo to $1, it is now 500 naira to $1. Who caused it? Bad government by Fulani people. But you will never hear them say, let us get jobs, let us build houses, let us introduce a social welfare package that will benefit everybody. Let us eradicate all these bottlenecks that corruption has created. No, never. This is insecurity. China, come and help us. US, come. UK, come. Insecurity. They think those people are foolish. Do you think that had China treated its people the same way you're treating your so-called foolish Nigerians, that China would be great today? For you to be running to them? For many years, for decades, Igbo man is the problem. Do not support Biafra. They will do this, they will do that. Now, their land has been taken away. They have renamed some places in Benue State to Fulani names. Decades of being fed on a diet of hatred for the Igbos and Biafra. That is why now they are being slaughtered. Nobody is talking about the Benue people leaving their homes and living in refugee camps. Nobody. Sultan won't. Because they are his people doing the slaughtering and the killing. They are all part and parcel of the agenda, the Islamites.